Hello everyone, in this video we're going to talk about using the FOIL method to multiply two polynomials. Okay, so let's start with a simple method. So as you know, if this is my polynomial a plus b and this is my second polynomial c plus d, we're going to use the FOIL method. And what does FOIL stand for? It stands for the particular steps that you must apply to solve this polynomial multiplication, to find the resulting product, okay? So FOIL means, F means first, O means outer, I means inner, and L means last. And what do those steps really mean? Let me show you what it is. So A, so when you have A plus B and then C plus D multiplying, the a will be multiplied to c first, okay? And that's called the first, okay? Then then we will have the outer step, and the outer means the extremes, okay, the farthest from each other. And the farthest from each other will be the A and D, right? Because there's nothing farther than the A and D from each other. So that's called the outer. Then we will have the inner. The inner means the closest ones. The closest ones are B and C, right? So that is the inner step. And by the way, these are steps products, right? Product, each step, okay? Each step is a product. So now this is the inner step. And finally, the last step, the last step will be the B and D product. Last. Okay? And remember that these products will be added. Okay? So you're going to be the sum. You're talking about the sum of all products. Is the product of A plus B and C plus D, the sum of all products. So, and as I said before, each step, let me just write it as first product, the outer product, the inner product, and the last product. Okay, so now as an example, let's do a quick example. Let's take x plus 3 multiplied to 2y minus 4x. So what is the first step? The first step involves the first two terms in each factor. The first two terms are x and 2y. So x will be multiplied 2y. So as a result, we get 2xy. And remember that we're looking for the sum of all of these steps, the F, O, I, and L. What is the outer pair? The outer pair will be x multiplied to the minus 4x, the farthest away from each other, right? So that will give us plus, because we're going to add all of them, even if we have minus signs, we're going to keep it inside the parentheses and then simplify later. So minus 4x squared, right? Because minus 4x times x is minus 4x squared, close parentheses. Then the inner product. The inner product will be the closest two guys, the closest two terms, which is 3 and 2y. So they multiply each other to give us 6y. And then finally, the last step will involve 3 and negative 4x. The last two terms in each factor. The last terms in each factor, right? So it's going to be negative, well, we're going to add first, and then we're going to put the minus sign inside the parentheses, minus 12x, right? Because 3 times negative 4 is negative 12. So negative 12x. Now we're ready to simplify. The simplification is 2xy minus 4x squared, right? Because plus minus gives you a minus. Plus 6y minus 12x. Are there any like terms? No, right? Because every combination of variables, whether they're by themselves or involves another variable, is unique. So there's no term that matches the other term anywhere. There are four distinct terms. We cannot combine them. This is the simplest form of the product of these two polynomials that we had originally. Okay? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care.